No, most durable amateur fight that you can remember.
Yeah, I love you.
I think the second time I won the Golden Gloves, man. But I won the Golden Boy Award, like the most outstanding fighter. In Reno, Nevada. I fought Tim Bradley in the finals. Actually, Floyd Mayweather, he was there watching me. He took me and all my friends out to eat afterwards as a congratulations dinner. That was dope. And, you know, like I say, the Olympics, man, he's me. And it's hard to beat that Olympic situation. So, you know, just walking in open ceremony was dope.
Berto, how do you explain it that you're a boxer, there are millions of boxers out there, you fight, fans love your style, but the local TV here in LA, they all love you. Why is that? Why did they love putting you on?
Man, I don't know.
What do you think? Because you speak your mind? What is it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm one of those fighters that's in the mix of the entertainment situation as well. So, I mean, so they're always on my Instagram. And
they find a lot of famous friends, too.
Yeah, so they find shit, they grab it and post it. You know what I mean? So, I guess it's what it is.
Is it tough being famous, though? Because you want some privacy sometimes. You're walking out of a club and you got 10 cameras on you.
Yeah,
you can't walk out with any girl you meet in the club or
exactly,
something.
Exactly. No, shit gets too crazy, man. So, I don't really... And then, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, nowadays, I don't really go out too much to clubs at all. I really just train and, you know, kick with some of the friends, like in private areas. Like, just got my membership at the Soul House. It's a private spot, so I'm going to try to kick it and get low key, man.
Tell me about the time that you and Amir Khan went to watch the Mike Tyson one-man show.
Yeah.
What was that like? And did you get to meet Tyson over there and talk
to
him? What was that like?
Yeah, you know, I've known Tyson for a long time, man. Actually, we were in a movie together a long time ago.
What movie was that?
The Cookout 2. The Cookout 2. A movie called The Cookout 2. As I know Mike for years, man, you know what I mean? He called me that time when he was open. He was on the show. I brought him in, brought everybody out. You know what I mean? Got a chance to meet Mike and, you know, kick with him. Because I know Mike for years. And a great guy, man. The boxing game kind of fucked his head up a little bit. You know, you get a guy from nothing, make so much money, and you know, so many people take advantage of you. I mean, he'll put you in a different space. So, you know, like I say, all in all, he's a good dude, man.
Do you give him advice or does he give you advice when it comes to boxing?
Both.
Oh, how does it work?
With boxing, of course he gives me advice.
What does he tell you? Like what?
You know, he's just, you know what I mean, Mike is just Mike, man. He always tells me, what he used to tell me? He used to tell me to never take anything personal. He used to tell me don't fall in love with the boxing game. Always think about it as business. But it's, like I say, it's hard to do that, especially, you know, when you've been doing something for so long, you know, so passionately, you know, it's hard not to fall in love with it. So I think he was just pretty much, you know, talking about just the criticism, you know, you can think you're on top one day and everybody loves you, and then when it turns on you, you know, so he doesn't want you to put your feelings in your heart so much in it, just think of it as, you know, I mean, as a business, as a job, so.